Hi, my name is Chuck Reese, and I'm a senior software engineer on the Visual Studio Debugger. I've been working on Visual Studio for almost 10 years now, and in that time I've gotten to work on some really exciting features related to debug symbols and debug sources. Today we're going to take a look at some of the awesome new features in Visual Studio 2022 related to debug symbols and external code debugging, as well as looking at some common symbol-related scenarios that you might run into in your everyday life. Come with me, let's explore. Debug symbols are an essential part of debugging. Here I have a simple console app where I'm stopped at a breakpoint, I can see the local variables, and I can see the call stack. While the values of these local variables are coming from the target application, things like their names and the line info that allows us to set this breakpoint and stop at it are coming from the debug symbols, which is the PDB file. If we want information about the symbols that are currently loaded for the target process, we can get this through the modules window, which we find through debug, windows, modules. Here we can see every DLL that's loaded into the target process, as well as its symbol status. For our app DLL, symbol demo console.dll, we can see that we have loaded symbols. We can see the path that symbols were loaded from. This path is the build output that was generated when we built the application as part of F5. We can see that this module is not optimized while the other .NET runtime modules are. Therefore, our app is considered user code because we built it, while the .NET runtime, which we did not build, is not considered user code. As such, we can see that through symbol status that symbols were not loaded for the .NET runtime DLLs. If we ever want more information about why symbols weren't loaded, we can use the context menu in the modules window to look at symbol load information. This will give us a log or list of reasons of where the debugger looked for symbols or why it didn't look at all. In this case, we can see that the option Just My Code is enabled. Just My Code is a debugger feature that keeps us hyper-focused on only the code that we write, so we don't have to be distracted by code that we didn't write, such as the .NET runtime in this case. Just My Code is one of several features or several debugger settings that can affect symbol load behavior that we'll look at today. Visual Studio gives us complete control over where the debugger will look for symbol files and whether or not they should be loaded. These options are available through Debug, Options, Symbols. Here we've opted into Microsoft Symbol Servers as well as NuGet Symbol Servers. This will allow us to download symbols for popular Microsoft dependencies and NuGet packages from the internet. You can also set the location on disk where these symbols will be downloaded and cached. I like to use a simple short path that I can share with other diagnostic tools that will require symbols. Finally, we can choose whether we always want to load symbols for every module, or if we want to specify exactly which module symbols should be loaded for. Using this list can help to scope down how many symbol files are downloaded and loaded by the debugger. Even though we've opted in to load all modules and we've selected the public symbol servers, we can see that our current app has still not loaded symbols for things like Newtonsoft.json or the .NET runtime. If we look at symbol load information, this is because Just My Code is enabled. None of these dependencies were built by us, and therefore the debugger is trying to keep us out of that code. If we do, however, want to debug into external code, we can disable Just My Code through Options, General, Enable Just My Code. Once we do this, we can see that symbols will begin to download for external dependencies, and now we have symbols loaded for Newtonsoft. Once we have Just My Code disabled and we have symbols loaded for Newtonsoft, we can even begin to step into its code and download it using source link from its GitHub repo. Now we can debug into Newtonsoft.json and explore or find the issue that we were originally looking for. We can even go one step further and step into the .NET runtime itself, also from GitHub. This is an easy way to debug external code in Visual Studio. For simple console apps, loading all symbols at all times may work fine, but for larger, more complex apps with more external dependencies, this can cause a performance issue on start debugging as the debugger tries to download all symbols from the internet. For example, here we have an ASP.NET Core MVC app with Just My Code disabled and set to load all modules. When we start debugging, we can see that it actually takes much longer than we would expect for the server to start. This is because Visual Studio is downloading symbols from the internet for everything in the ASP.NET framework. Normally our breakpoint would be hit by now. We can work around this by going back to our symbols menu and changing from load all modules to load only specified modules. All the code that we built ourselves will still be loaded. And if we want any external symbols to load, we can list them here. For now, let's just start. And we'll hit our breakpoint very quickly because we're not downloading all symbols from the internet. The server spins up, we see our web page load, and we hit our breakpoint. Now, because we have JMC disabled, because we have just my code disabled, we can see all of the non-user code frames in the call stack. However, none of these have symbols loaded. If we try to navigate to one, we will see the no symbols loaded page, which gives us an explanation of why this PDB was not loaded. In this case, it is not in our include list. We can load symbols directly from here, and thanks to SourceLink, we'll immediately get source code for the .NET, for the ASP.NET Core framework. If we want to load symbols automatically all the time for any module from the call stack window, we can right click and say always load automatically. This will automatically add things to our symbols list. I like to use this feature to build up the list of symbols that I care about over time as I find them in the wild. One of my favorite new features in Visual Studio 2022 is the Debugger External Sources node. Once we start debugging, you can see a new node appear in Solution Explorer called External Sources. This node allows us to view all the source files for a given dependency and even load symbols. Here we'll load symbols for Newtonsoft.json. Once the symbols load, we can see all the C# files that were built to create Newtonsoft.json. We can also do this for system.private.corelib. Now it's as if we're looking at the entire .NET runtime GitHub repo. In fact, we can go to system.collections.generic and even set breakpoints. Here in dictionary.c, we can search for the add function. Once we find it, we can set a breakpoint and we can run to it. This is a great way to go exploring and read code in external libraries that you may not be familiar with. It's awesome for debugging and code exploration. I'm really excited about it. When just my code is enabled, Visual Studio will not step into external code. For example, if I try to step into the .NET dictionary class, it will become a step over. This is because symbols are not loaded for the .NET runtime and it is considered external code. Visual Studio 2022 has some awesome new behavior to make this experience better. If we want to step into external code, we can disable just my code, and then for performance reasons that we've discussed previously, we'll switch to load only specified modules. When Visual Studio is in this symbols configuration, it will do some awesome deferred symbol load for us. For example, we can see that for system.private.corelib, symbols are not currently loaded, so we didn't pay the cost to load them on F5. However, when we try to step into dictionary, Visual Studio knows that we need symbols. It will download them automatically, get source from SourceLink, and put us right into the dictionary class. We can continue to step in. We can see that symbols were loaded, and this allows us to go exploring an external code without paying the upfront cost of downloading and loading symbols. This behavior is really awesome, and it's brand new in Visual Studio 2022. Sometimes symbols just aren't available for an external dependency. Either they haven't been published or we don't have access to anywhere that they were published. In these cases, Visual Studio can help us by decompiling the external dependency and showing us decompiled source code. In this case, we can see that we have an external dependency for which Visual Studio could not find the PDB. If we check out the symbol load information, it will tell us everywhere that it looked, but it's simply unavailable to us. Or maybe the PDB doesn't even exist anymore. In these cases, we can right-click from the modules window and choose decompile source to symbol file. Once the decompilation is finished, we can even step into our external dependency and see decompiled source code. We can even step through it and view values in the watch window, and all debugging simply works. This is an awesome feature and a great way to explore external code in Visual Studio. One of the most important uses of debug symbols is for dump debugging. Here I have a crash dump for a managed app that I made. I didn't build the version of this app on my machine, and in fact, I don't even have the repo cloned currently. When I try to debug this with dump debugging, it can't find the PDB. Like I said, I didn't build it on this machine. Luckily, this app was built through Azure DevOps, and I can see here that I used the publish symbol steps in pipelines to publish the symbols that were created to Azure DevOps symbol server. In Visual Studio, I can go to New Azure DevOps Symbol Server and add my Azure DevOps instance. Once that's added, I can load symbols from Azure DevOps, and because the application was built with SourceLink, everything just works. Now I can debug the silly issue that I had. Thanks for joining me today. In Visual Studio 2022, we're making it the easiest it's ever been to debug external sources through the External Sources node, deferred symbol loading, and decompilation. I also hope that you learned something about how to get the best symbol-related experience out of Visual Studio. Happy coding!